a smooth, sensual disco-inspired ballad. Michael Jackson's Rock With You was his biggest single up till this point, and solidified Jackson as a rising musical powerhouse irrespective of his earlier childhood success. Rock With You was a clear attempt to reinvent the artist, not only shifting public perceptions of the singer away from his former teeny bopper image, but also to give the audience a glimpse of Michael Jackson as a man and seductive lover. Considered to be one of the last hits of the disco era, the single, along with Jackson's accompanying album, achieved mainstream success unprecedented for a black artist at the time. The single is significant as it is Michael Jackson's first attempt at genre blending, which later became so instrumental in his rise to mainstream superstardom. This is the story behind the inspiration, production, and commercial reaction to one of pop history's most iconic musical releases, Michael Jackson's 1979 hit, Rock With You. But first, if you are interested in understanding the man, the music, and the magic behind Michael Jackson, we are your dedicated channel. So hit subscribe and that bell notification as we tackle all things MJ with two new videos every week. Also, check out our store for original MJ-inspired styles. A great gift for any Michael Jackson fan. Link is in the description below. The inspiration. After Michael Jackson had starred in The Wiz in 1978, he approached the film's musical director Quincy Jones to ask if he knew of any producers to help with future solo projects. As a result of this conversation, Jones suggested himself, and they agreed to work together. As a member of the Jacksons, Michael was keen to branch out on his own and explore creatively with his own music. His father Joe was not keen on the project as he felt it would distract him from what should be his main focus, the group, but was persuaded with the promise that it wouldn't interfere with Michael's commitments to his brothers and the family business. At 20 years old, this was Michael Jackson's opportunity to reinvent himself from his Motown bubblegum pop image. Revealing his development as an artist, his own distinct sound away from his brothers and other popular artists at the time. As a Motown artist and then progressing into R&B, disco, and funk, Michael Jackson was frustrated with the music industry and how they were quick to label and box in artists, limiting their audience to a particular niche. Saying at the time, "I hate labels because it should be just music. Call it disco, call it anything, it's music to me." Jackson also saw firsthand how these limitations placed on him were all too often racially motivated. They categorize, they get a little bit too racial about things when it should all be together. Our main goal in music is to integrate every race to one through music, and we're doing that. The production. During the production of Off the Wall, Quincy Jones encouraged Jackson to write his own music, but also reached out to various known songwriters within the industry for a potential hit. Rod Temperton, keyboardist and primary songwriter in the group Heatwave, wrote their 1977 hit Boogie Nights, which caught the attention of Jones, who enlisted Temperton to write songs for Jackson. Jones was keen for Jackson to push himself, to show maturity in the record, and reveal a more sensual side of him as an artist. Rock With You was originally written by Temperton for Karen Carpenter, who was at the time recording her ill-fated solo record. Wanting to move away from the Carpenter sound she had become synonymous with, she gravitated towards more disco and up-tempo numbers. The original title for the song was I Want to Eat You Up, and although Karen was keen to explore more mature lyrics, she rejected the song for being too sexually suggestive. When the song was later presented to Jackson, he agreed to record it, but the title was quickly changed to Rock With You to fit Jackson's wholesome heartthrob image. The song is on the surface about dancing, but the sexual subtext is clear. Jackson wants his girl to relax and let the music take over her body. But when they share that beat of love, it's not likely to happen on the dance floor. At the time when rock was used as a verb in a song title, it typically meant to play or enjoy rock music. For example, Kiss's Rock and Roll All Night. However, Jackson's interpretation appropriated it as another way to describe dancing while implying something more. Terms like boogie and groove were often used in this context, but weren't incorporated into the song because how closely they were linked to disco, which could potentially limit Jackson to a narrower audience. Using the word rock was Jackson's first attempt at crossing the boundaries of genre, positioning himself as a mainstream crossover superstar. The video. Although all of Michael Jackson's music videos are now referred to as short films, the short films for Off the Wall are more classic music videos, as they are performance clips rather than scripted stories. Working in a pre-MTV era, Michael's short film for Rock With You was the second of three short films produced for recordings from Off the Wall. Bruce Gowers, the video pioneer and director behind Queen's Bohemian Rhapsody, created a smoky space tunnel in an LA soundstage for a glimmering Michael Jackson to shine. In a sequin jumpsuit and matching boots against a set of bedazzling lasers, Michael danced joyously while the lights illuminated his outfit from behind. Although Jackson's slick presentation looks $1 million, Gowers recalls the tight budget they had to work with. In those days, they were done for peanuts. Absolute peanuts. I think about all we could afford was the laser. This one was probably about $3,000. If you look at it, there's nothing there but a laser and Michael Jackson. The music video was filmed on a small soundstage in LA called the 800 Stage, which Gower was able to get cheap because they were also shooting the music video for She's Out of My Life that same day. Budget restraints also extended to the video's editing, because in those days, editing cost money. Gowers recounted, "It was about $350 per machine per hour. If you were using two playbacks and one record, that was a lot of money. Everything was rented, trust me. The cameras, the stage, the backdrop, the smoke." However, the video's simplicity allowed Jackson's star power to shine through, despite his modest demeanor on set. As Bruce Gower remembers, "When we did this, this was the start of his solo career. He was very timid, very quiet, very unassuming. Really nice, he was an absolute professional even in those days." The release. The second single from Michael Jackson's Off the Wall album hit the shelves on November the 3rd, 1979. It became Michael Jackson's third number one on the Billboard Hot 100 and spent four consecutive weeks at the top, starting January 19, 1980. The song was also the fourth biggest single of 1980, a decade whose pop singles chart would soon be dominated by Jackson. Rock With You was also considered one of the last hits of the disco era. When disco was supposed to be sleeping with the fishes, Michael Jackson landed a laid-back romantic disco song, proving that Jackson, who was well-suited for the dance beats of disco and was able to work in the genre even when it was well past its prime. But what separates Rock With You is that it almost acknowledges the winding down of the era. It was more smoothed out than even the tracks that accompanied it on Off the Wall. Performed during the Jackson's Destiny, Triumph, and Victory concerts, as well as during Jackson's solo Bad, Dangerous, and History tours, Rock With You had become, up until this point, Michael Jackson's biggest solo success. In 2000, the song was ranked number 82 on Rolling Stone and MTV's list of the 100 greatest pop songs. Check out our channel for more Michael Jackson videos, and also visit our MJ store by clicking our link in the description. Thank you for watching The Detail. We'll see you next time.